time series. Tonight's final round of the iPone 600 series will be conducted over three races, each six laps in duration. Aiden Hayes is 14 points behind series leader Jack Passfield and is determined to claim as many points as possible. Currently in second place, can he take the title?
Being under lights, the whole experience of being under floodlights, you're not going to get that anywhere else in Australia.
To me, the difference between the Summer Night Series and any other race series, it's like the speedway of road racing. It's really short, sharp racing.
For us to have it here in Sydney and to have the lights here at Sydney Motorsport Park is, I don't have words to explain, it's just amazing.
Your focus seems to be so much more intent and so much more precise because there's just no grass, there's no hills, there's no grandstand. It's amazing how it gets rid of the noise around you.
And I've been racing for 20 years and this has only just started. Bloody fantastic.
I'm excited to try and see what times I can do without Jack here and see how we go. Try and hold on to either second or move up to first in the points. No rain predicted and it's dry track, so it's perfect.
Motorcycling around the country, it stayed so stagnant for so many years, and when you get the opportunity to get on the lights and do something completely different, there was no other choice but to do it.
When the lights were put in sort of a year and a half ago, I think there were a lot of questions about how it would be for the riders.
At the times there was many problems that we had to jump. Getting people to support it and believe it could actually work and it could make it happen. Putting water on the track to mimic rain nights, mucking around with visors and different levels of visors and just different tent levels and trying to get the vision to make sure it was actually correct and safe. And at the end of the day, safety's the key thing.
All the riders I know absolutely love the series. They've just taken to it.
You've got to be on fire from the minute you get here. It's fantastic. It's like get off, stop sweating, have a drink of water, gas the bike up and crack and going again.
So you have such short time between your races. Just having that quick burst of races is such a buzz.
You hear it's done in 4 hours. You know, the night starts at 6:30, we finished at 10:30. It's just a really extreme, high intense pressure for 4 hours.
I don't even know why I bring a chair. I don't get a minute to sit down in it. So it presents a different challenge, which is great.
Hayes has the credentials, having competed at many world-class venues, but can he do it tonight?
I'd have known Aiden now for probably 4 or 5 years, probably the last 3 years pretty intently and pretty closely with him. He's just a genuinely honest bloke. Gets out there, tries his heart out. You probably won't find anyone trains harder for the sport. Generally just one of those really nice blokes that's out there.
We were set for the third race and just as we were trying to get the warmer off, the tyre warmer got stuck on the rim.
Not in pit lane or on the grid, where's the 46?
We couldn't get out before the pit lane closed, so we had to start the third race from pit lane and starting from dead last. Trying to hunt down to get to first.
Hayes has now got to fight his way through to the front.
Pit lane start races are amazing, like you're frustrated when you're there, but Freddie Spencer once actually said to me, he goes, they're the ones you'll remember.
Look at that, as Hayes weaves his way through the field. What a great display of skill and determination. But can he continue the momentum over the remaining three laps? His challenge will undoubtedly be to keep it upright on the black stuff and not make any mistakes. Hayes is getting closer to our race leader, Derek Murphy, but is it too little too late?
Got it. I caught up to him. I came through the field, but I missed out on first by 0.033 of a second.
Oh my God! What a race!
I mean, I'm happy. I was on a charge, but didn't quite get there.
Even though runner-up in the final race, he still claims the championship.
He never gives up when he's attacking. It's just amazing that last race tonight. It's fantastic to watch.
The onboard footage of that gives you, and the vision it gives you, hanging off the side of a bike with the head over a ripple strip, there's nothing like it. So foresight's taking it to a whole new level.
It's been really good, so I can come in and I can have a look at the footage, especially if I've made mistakes, I can try and have a look and see if I did something wrong. Apart from that as well, I can see where people pass me and then I can look back on their footage, I can see what they're doing different and then I can try and go out and mimic it and see if I can improve my lap time. So that works out really well for me, it's nice and easy.
Massive thanks to Foresight and Helmets for coming out and supporting me and showing everyone what it's all about, and big thanks to Dylan for everything he does and helps me out. It's good.
The future of the Summer Night Series, we're looking at running a back-to-back events in December, January coming up.
But I think they're building it up and up and it's getting bigger and better.
It's getting a lot more attention. I would love to see it grow, and I think that is exactly what's going to happen.
I love being part of the circus. And this is a fantastic experience.
G'day, Cam here. This was actually the very first sports bike slash race coverage video we've ever done. It was a huge effort to shoot this, but we had an absolute blast making it. But if you want to see more of this kind of video in the future, please hit like and subscribe and let us know what you think in the comments below. And we'll see you in the next one.